Greetings all, welcome to my video. From CollectiveEvolution.com. The United States tried to detonate a nuclear weapon on the moon and something responded when we did. By Arjun Walia. In the 1950s, Colonel Ross Dedrickson was responsible for maintaining the inventory of the nuclear weapon stockpile for the AEC and for accompanying security teams, checking out the security of the weapons, among many other duties. As his obituary states, he was assigned to the U.S. Atomic Energy Commission. A long service with the Energy Commission between 1950 to 1958 included contract administration duties at Nevada test sites, Pacific Nuclear Test Area west of Hawaii, nuclear weapon manufacturing, and quality assurance in Albuquerque, and inspection of nuclear and non-nuclear facilities throughout the country. He served with the 5th Air Force in Japan, and later as a ranking colonel, officer in charge of the Pacific Unified Command Alternate, Command and Control Center in Hawaii. In 1962, he was transferred, and served as deputy, for material for the 832 Air Division at Cannon Air Force Base, Clovis, New Mexico. He retired from the USAF in 1964. He is one of hundreds of military whistleblowers, with verified backgrounds, to have been brought forth by Dr. Stephen Greer's Disclosure Project. His testimony about UFOs, specifically about UFOs, and nuclear weapons, can be corroborated by a wealth of information, and evidence, that's now available within the public domain. Many of these whistleblowers have made multiple appearances at the National Press Club, in an effort to get this information out to the world, with the most recent example being the Citizens' Hearing on Disclosure, which took place a few years ago. With such a professional background, working in the places he has worked, it's safe to infer he was privy to sensitive information on a number of subjects. This isn't just a random high-ranking military whistleblower talking about a random issue. There are many whistleblowers and documents clearly outlining a decades-long relationship between UFOs and nuclear storage facilities and test sites. You can read more about that in the article linked below. A number of these incidents have visual confirmation, along with air and ground radar confirmation as well. Related CE article, this is what happens when a UFO is tracked on military radar. In the interview below, Dedrickson explains how the American government tried to detonate a nuclear weapon on the moon, but were prevented from doing so. As far as the mainstream goes, it's public knowledge that a declassified report by the Air Force Nuclear Weapons Center from June 1959 shows just how seriously they considered the plan, called Project A-119. In general, they wanted to investigate the capability of weapons in space, as well as gain further insight into the space environment, and the detonation of nuclear devices within it. As far as the information below, that probably goes deeper into the black budget. It's interesting how the world is so into television shows, like Stranger Things, which depicts the Department of Energy, and their involvement with otherworldly creatures, and other strange facts, yet so willing to ignore a high-ranking American colonel, who held very sensitive positions at the Department of Energy for years, at a time when all of this nuclear development was really hot. He is the real deal, and it's interesting to ponder what he might really know. I also learned about incidents involving nuclear weapons, and among these incidents, were a couple of nuclear weapons sent into space, were destroyed by the extraterrestrials, at the very end of the 70s, and the early 80s, we attempted to put a nuclear weapon on the moon, and explode it for scientific measurements and other things, which was not acceptable to the extraterrestrials. They destroyed the weapon before it got to the moon. Thank you for watching. Please help spread the word and make a difference by sharing and subscribing for more thought-provoking content, and give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Your support is greatly appreciated. Be aware and stay safe.